All right, here's contest number three. Nothing but orange at 30 yards. So I think we're putting the large fluorescent orange target. It's a sticker, we stick it onto the piece of foam there. Your arrow has to be completely inside of the orange dot. If it's touching the white,
I made my quarters back.
Then it doesn't count. And so at this point, I forget to turn the camera back at the shooter, so there's not going to be a whole lot going on except the arrow is hitting the bale. And also, since Jonah won the last contest, he gets bumped to shooting last. I won the first contest, so I'm second to the last. Actually, Manny is coming in late, so he's actually going to shoot last, completely last. So, here we go, we'll see what happens. It'd be kind of nice if I had two cameras, one shooting the target and one pointing at the shooters. I only have one camera, so what you gonna do? Alright, so there's the first arrow. I believe that was Jerry's arrow. So, slightly off. Oh, I'm sorry, that's Al's arrow. Al got to shoot first. That's right. That's Casey's arrow. His is a really thin arrow. It's primarily used for target shooting. So supposedly the thinner the arrow, the truer it'll fly. It'll fly straight. Not really sure whose arrow. That might be Arlene's arrow. She has green and white touching. Green knock on that. So nobody's hitting the foam yet. That's pretty sad. Usually we're pretty good. We hit the foam at least. Alright. That's probably Jerry. So Jerry hit the foam. Jerry's usually pretty good, pretty consistent. He's shooting a Martin Moab, which is a really nice single cam bow.
Oh, Danny.
Not sure whose arrow that is. It might be Roland's arrow. He's got the Incredible Hulk bow, the nice green riser. Like everybody's shooting to the left. Might be because of the wind. There's a slight breeze out there. Woo! Somebody got hit! Might be Donald's arrow. I guess that's one of the negatives of shooting last, is that you have all these arrows blocking the target. So you can get deflected. But nobody's hit the orange yet, so orange is free. That's Darren's arrow, shot way up high. He actually wasn't shooting. This is the first time I think he shot that day. And he's not shooting with sight or peep, and he's shooting with fingers. So. You'll probably see in the following videos, he's pretty dead on after that. Once he gets himself sighted in. Kind of amazes me how he can shoot like that with no peep, no sight, and no trigger. And he's pretty accurate. He's pretty accurate. Gee, I think up to like 40 yards. Oh, there's mine. If I hit inside the arch, probably at around 8 o'clock or so, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, and it's completely inside of the arch. So now if somebody else shoots, I think Jonah is after me. If he's able to get it inside of the arch, then we'll have a shoot-off. The shoot-off is closest to the bull, so you only get one arrow. You have to make the count and try and shoot as close to the center of the bullseye as possible. Well, Jonah went far to the right.
Alright. I guess it's you and I doing
it. And here comes latecomer Manny. He's talking a little bit of trash there. He thinks that he's gonna get a shoot off with me. And Manny's pretty accurate. He's usually pretty good, so. So he ends up hitting my arrow. Probably if my arrow wasn't there, it would have probably gone into the orange. But he hit my arrow and it got deflected outside of the orange. So that doesn't count. And I take the pot again. And at this point, everybody's getting kind of disgruntled that the it's kind of a one-sided contest right now. One-sided tournament.
So good thing you had the camera fish in there. Yeah, I guess so.
But you know, it was Arlene's idea to start the tournament. She brought out her little can of coins and shook it around and tried to get everybody involved. So yeah, there's Manny all the way to the left. Casey's right in the front of the camera there.
This is going on YouTube.
Jonah's in the orange. There's Arlene with her little Fidel Castro hat on. And I'm just outside of the camera view to the right there. Yeah, some of these arrows penetrate deeper than others. Probably the poundage is a little bit higher. And then also some arrows are, like the thinner arrows penetrate deeper. And then these bales are just made out of carpet, squished together by this wooden frame. So they grab on.
It wasn't a nice shot.